Jenny Lauren Dowden for Conduit News. Today we have former State Senator Bryan King joining us once again. Last week you were here talking with us about gerrymandering, the drawing of the lines, and how that can affect, of course, the election. But that's not the only way to possibly rig an election or have a different outcome. We want to talk with you today about audits. Just first, give me your overall impression on what you're seeing across the nation. There's lots of discussion regarding audits. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, you know, and I go back and some of the things I've done. I've been a past county election commissioner. I've been a past county election chairman. I've been involved in elections for several years, especially in Arkansas, where, you know, despite what they said, there were a lot of elections stolen in Arkansas. I mean, there were. And so whenever they came out after the election and had the audits, I was going to be very shocked if anything substantial came out of the audits. And I think we basically see that now there has not been anything come out of the audits. And that doesn't mean that there wasn't something happening. I'm not going to say there is something that happened, criminal or fraud related. But yet I can tell you that a lot of times the audits will not produce what people think they will. From a fraud case, if that actually happened in election.
So talk to us a little bit about what that looks like. A lot of people think, well, if a ballot was cast, you know, perhaps we can find out if there was, you know, anything nefarious going on, but it's not that simple, is it?
No, not with elections. And that's what is so much different. People think of fraud in a case. And let's say, for example, I get in your purse and I steal a check. Okay. And then I take that check and then I cash it, or I use it to purchase something. There's a trail with that. You know, with ballots, there's not. So Jenny, if you go in and cast a ballot, and if that ballot is frauded or in somewhere in the registration process from the time that ballot is cast, if there's some type of fraud, you know, once that ballot's cast, it has no memory of who cast it. And it's very hard to trace that. That's why election integrity measures on the front end are very, very important and need to be implemented, despite the case that you don't see an actual fraud case. You know, like I said, we look at it from a fraud case of if we have something stolen, it's taken to a pawn shop, it's taken and sold to an individual, you know, so there's a trace. You know, with ballots, that's not possible. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people have been disenfranchised with the election process, especially coming out of 2020. And, you know, there was a recent Gallup poll and the majority was that they did not have faith in the system. Leading into Virginia last night, of course, we did see a win for Youngkin. New Jersey has yet to be called and there's still some doubt there. What do you say about those who feel disenfranchised now regarding the system?
Yeah, I think there is a need to address the system, and there's a reason why people don't trust the system. You know, in politics, I think Ross Perot several years ago said there's rules like in professional wrestling and there's rules and other things, but there's no rules in politics. And we seem to think there are a lot of rules, but yet, you know, a lot of times those rules are not followed or the rules are manipulated to determine an outcome, like I illustrated in gerrymandering, which is basically trying to rig election. So a lot of times you have situations out there where fraud occurred, but it's not that several years that it's determined how it happened. And I'll use the situations that you mentioned, New Jersey. So I'm a son of a Teamster, a shop steward. My dad was a shop steward with local age 23. And so I went to like union meetings. So I remember as a kid when Jimmy Hoffa went missing, and that has not been solved yet today. You have multiple books, investigations, and, you know, we still have not found it. And now on Fox News with Eric Shawn and Dan Moldava and some of, they think they may have discovered his body in a New Jersey landfill. So now they're trying to dig that back up. So a lot of times in these election fraud cases, we don't find out the answer of what actually happened 2 years later. And much the case of what happened with Hudson Hallam, a former colleague of mine that was a state rep that had to resign for voter fraud and mail-in ballot fraud.
You know, so on top of that, what would you mention, you know, voter integrity, putting, you know, procedures, laws, policies in place to protect it on the front end? What would that look like specifically?
Well, I think you have to look at, number one, photo ID. I was the author of the constitutional amendment implementing the photo ID. you have a photo ID that can be help give extra evidence in a case of somebody using it. It's an extra security measure. You know, it's a common use practice that's pretty much already happened. I think when it comes to mail-in ballot frauds, the potential to have fraud happen, as in the case of Hudson Hallam, it is very easy to fraud and very, very hard to catch. I mean, you can sit there and go out and say there's no fraud, and that happened in Arkansas. I mean, we had continual years that you knew it was going on. You would say it was going on, and as somebody that went through this, and they'd say, you're crazy, it's not happening. In fact, one of my colleagues, former Democrat, Uvalde Lindsay, who was a state senator, was quoted in the newspapers as saying there's no voter fraud in Arkansas. And then the next day, Hudson Hallam had to resign because of voter fraud. Now, listen, Uvalde Lindsay is a great Arkansan. He was a great legislator. He was a genius in economic development. In fact, a lot of the things that happened in Northwest Arkansas wouldn't have happened had Uvalde Lindsay not been the guy behind the scenes making it happen. He's a brilliant man. I mean, he was like, there was a long time ago, they had a commercial when E.F. Hutton speaks, everybody listens. Well, I'm going to tell you, I respected Uvalde Lindsay so much that when he spoke, I listened and I learned a lot from him. So, but when he made the comment, there's no voter fraud in Arkansas, he was just replicating something they didn't find. And that's what happens in Arkansas. You have to have prosecutors that are willing to go look. Many of the prosecutors won't go prosecute these cases. They won't go look because the same people that they have to go after are the same people counting the ballots in their election.
Yeah, and that's the tricky part. We've heard from the opposing side, they ridicule, make fun of, you know, they say, oh, they're just now talking about, you know, voter fraud and the audits, let it go. To me, there seems a bit of hypocrisy from the left regarding this, because we've seen in past years, whether it's Stacey Abrams, Hillary Clinton questioning 2016, it seems as though it's okay for them to talk about, well, you know, we don't know about this election, or there may be fraud there. You know, what are your thoughts on that? I would think that in the case that we talked about regarding gerrymandering, this would be an issue that everyone should come up to the table, you know, about, because at some point, one party or the other is not going to be in power.
Mm-hmm. Well, and it happens on both sides. I can tell you somebody that went up against the Democrat machine in elections and had to go through that process and endure that. I also went out and found voter registration fraud and actually had a TV reporter go interview people on TV that says, these are not my signatures. And then turned it over to the authorities of every scope that I could think of, and absolutely nothing happened. So in that case, no, they didn't go find any fraud because no, they didn't go look. I mean, so they almost can set up the facts that back up their facts that say that there's no voter fraud when they never went and looked in the first place. I mean, one time I went and called the election officials about something that was obviously blatantly wrong and couldn't be explained and literally got laughed at in my face. But now people don't need to think that this is just a Democrat issue, because I can tell you it's a Republican issue too. Right. And I had experiences in Republican primaries. Now you have a situation in Pulaski County where there's a big controversy over the Republican election officials that were there versus the Democrat employees that were administering election. You had a court case. So these things revolve around the issue of trust, the process. And sometimes you have election officials, because elections are not run near as often as, you know, a common task, you know, that just don't go right. And there are a lot of good people out there on both sides. I had a friend of mine that was a Democrat county clerk that I would trust immensely. I've had Republicans that I wouldn't trust any farther than I can move the Empire State Building. So it's really an issue of who's in control, who's in power, because as we talked about, I think we touched on last time, it may be the establishment and in the inner powers that do not want a Republican in there. And the Republican, and this just gets into a larger issue, I hope you get me to come back to some of the things I addressed, is that people need to look at it. It's just not a Democrat issue. It's a politician issue. It's a political issue. And I've seen it happen in Republican cases. In one of my elections, you know, they were counting ballots without notifying anybody. I was never notified. That's illegal. They can't do that without a public meeting. I've had somebody that worked for a Republican election official campaigning on on government time against me making deals with a particular candidate to try and help them win. I mean, that's just as illegal as it legal gets, and it's on the Republican side. So, you know, there has to be a fair standard of what is really happening here. What is the situation? And the standard is trying to find integrity, because like I said, things flipped with now Republicans controlling the election commissions. And if you look at the Pulaski County example, where there was lawsuits, there was interviews, it went to a possible vote. I can go back in Arkansas history where you had Senator Crumley, who was seated, where we knew there was a Senate trial and there was obvious fraud happened, but they couldn't identify. Once again, it gets back why election integrity matters so much on the front end. Like in the Senator Crumley case, he still got seated, even though there was admitted fraud and we knew fraud happened, but yet he still got seated. And the outcome still wound up being that he was elected and served. And right. So that's why election integrity issues on the front end are so very, very important.
How can we restore that trust that's been broken between the people and those in power?
Yeah, I think you have to have methods and practices in place that a candidate, no matter who they are, on the Democrat side or the Republican side or Libertarian or Green, Independent, that can look at the process. The first thing that doesn't need to happen, and it always happens, is, well, the thing of you're a sore loser. You know, the situation I mentioned that happened to me in 2012, I wound up still being the winner. But yet, even though there were illegal activities that actually happened, there was no recourse for me to do anything. The prosecutor wasn't going to do anything. The state officials were not going to do anything. The Republican Party just turned a blind eye and let them go ahead and commit acts that were, illegal and not ethically correct. There was nothing going to happen. So there's literally no accountability and a standard that say, you know, and there's also standards of people or election officials that, quite frankly, in some cases are incompetent. And those people have to be removed. If you have election commissioner, Democrat, Republican, that is operating unethically or trying to cause trouble, you have to have also measures that allow a candidate to say, you know, I want a recount. Right now, the current process is to have a recount and look at it. You have to come up with your own money. Even though this is a government paid for election, even though these are partisan political appointees that run the election, you have also government employees, you know, county officials mostly that help with the elections. Even though you have those things happen, they can have incompetence or malfeasance or something go wrong, and a candidate has to basically prove all of that himself. That shouldn't happen. There should be entities out there that come in, and we can talk about that later another time where it shows I tried to actually address that, and Democrats stopped it at one time, and Republicans stopped it at the other time, because once again, once the establishment gets in there, once they have their powers, they want a process that is manipulated. And that shows in the USA Today poll that shows that a majority of elections don't trust the election process, because you have these establishment powers that are trying to rig elections, manipulate elections in a lot of different ways that determine that, you know, what was it, almost 60%, I think, the people in that poll. That shows you that that's a problem with people, that they don't trust elections, and measures have to happen. And it's not going to happen with the powers that we have in there right now.
Well, as always, you bring great insight to this, and we appreciate you coming on Conduit. And we do look forward to having you on again soon.
Yeah, thanks. And it's going to be interesting to see the New Jersey case. Like I mentioned, you know, maybe Jimmy Hoffa's buried there, and that mystery may be solved. And I think in the New Jersey, with the election too close to call, you know, what's going to happen after that election? You know, there needs to be a process, because, quite frankly, audits and recounts most generally will not reproduce what actually happened. These people that, if they want to commit fraud, and that happened here in Arkansas. I mean, we can look at the Hudson Hallam case, for example, and how the process is played out with these entities coming in with the thing, there was no voter fraud, they discredit things. Because once that certification happens, then the election's done. And that's why we have to do these things. And we have to say, you know what, we need to look at these things. There need to be entities. There needs to be money spent. A candidate in Arkansas, whether they're a Democrat or Republican, does not need to come up with their own money to request a recount.
Well, thank you so much for sharing that perspective. And, as always, we really appreciate you being on Conduit and look forward to talking to you again soon about this.
All right. Thank you, Jenny.